Hello, welcome once again to ASMNOFU online math class. In this video, we are going to discuss a nice topic in mathematics, which is the cumulative frequency curve, popularly known as the ogive. Kindly hit the red button to subscribe to my channel. It gives you notification whenever a new video is out. So this ogive is a popular WAEC question. It comes out every now and then in WAEC examination. And that is why I think is worthwhile I discuss this topic tonight so that it will help our WAEC student prepare and do well in their forthcoming examination. Okay, now, the ogive is just a graph whereby the cumulative frequency of a group of data is plotted against the upper class boundary. So the cumulative frequency stays at the vertical axis while the upper class boundary stays at the horizontal axis. Now, we are going to learn this cumulative frequency in this video, cumulative frequency curve in this video using this example here. So you can see that we are told that the table below shows the weekly profit in Naira from a mini market. You can see the weekly profit from 1 to 10, this is in Naira, 11 to 20, and the corresponding frequency. So we are asked to draw the cumulative frequency graph of the data. Then from the data, we should estimate the median, the lower quartile, the upper quartile, the interquartile range, semi-interquartile range, 80th percentile, and 60th decile. Nobody will ask you all these questions at the same time. They might pick two or three from it and ask you. But because of the fact that you wouldn't know the one that will come out in any examination you are going to face, that is why I deemed it fit that we discuss all of them, so that anyone that comes out, you'll be able to tackle it properly. Okay, now, the first thing to do in drawing the ogive is to first of all prepare a cumulative frequency table, because it will be from that cumulative frequency table that you'll be able to construct the ogive. Now, to draw the cumulative frequency table, you make a table just like I have done. You can see where I have the class intervals. The class interval is just the information given, which is the weekly profit of 1 to 10, 11 to 20, 21 to 30, etc. That is just what I've written down here under the class interval. Then you have to write the frequency. The frequency are 6, 6. So you put the frequency 6, 6, 12, 11, 10, and 5. I've just put the frequency accordingly where it is supposed to be. 6, 6, 12, 11, 10, and 5. Then after the frequency, there is what we call cumulative frequency. Because this cumulative frequency is the most important thing, we use it in plotting the ogive. It stays at the vertical axis. Cumulative frequency is just the gradual sum of the frequency. So from here, you are seeing your frequency. The first frequency here is 6, so you write 6. Then 6 plus 6 will give you 12. You see the way I'm going to know what you're going to have. Then I first of all wrote 6. 6 plus 6 is 12. 12 plus 12 will give us 24. 24 plus 11 will give us 35. 35 plus 10 will give us 45. And 45 plus 5 will give us 50. That is how to make the cumulative frequency. So when you make it, take note of it, because we are going to use it to plot at the vertical axis. That's the most important thing we need. After that, you need to get your class boundaries. The class boundary is got from the class interval. But the class boundary we need is the upper class boundary, because you have the lower class boundary and the upper class boundary. The lower class boundary is got from the lower class interval, while the upper class boundary is got from the upper class interval. Now, to get the lower class boundary, coming to the lower class interval, which is the first line here, everything down here, remove 0.5 from the lower class interval to get the lower class boundary. So from 1, I will remove 0.5. Then I will remove 0.5, I'll have 10.5. 21, I will remove 0.5, I have 20.5. 31, I remove 0.5, I'll have 30.5. 41, I will remove 0.5, I'll have 40.5. 51, I will remove 0.5, I will have 50.5. Then, I've got the lower class boundary, so let me go for the upper class boundary. To get the upper class boundary, you are adding 0.5 to the upper class interval to get the upper class boundary. That's the way to do it. So to get the upper class boundary here, I will just add 0.5 to 10. It will give me 10.5. Add 0.5 here, you have 20.5. Add 0.5 to 30, you have 30.5. Add 0.5 to 40, you have 40.5. Add 0.5 to 50, you have 50.5. Add 0.5 to 60, you have 60.5. So this is how to get the upper class boundary. So the trick is that to get the lower class boundary, you have to remove 0.5 from the lower class interval. Then to get the upper class boundary, add 0.5 to the upper class interval. That gives you the lower class, the upper class boundaries. There is a mathematical way of doing it to do the computation. But once you're inside examination hall, you don't need to waste your time. The trick is that you have to remove 0.5 from the lower class boundary, from the lower class interval, to get the lower class boundary. Then add 0.5 to the upper class interval to get the upper class boundary. That is just the way to do that. Okay, now you asterisk this because this will be at the horizontal, but the value we need here is just the upper class boundary. We don't need the lower class boundary, but I just need to tell you that how it is got, because using formula to calculate the median and other things, the lower class boundary is very necessary. That is why I told you how to get it. But in making the ogive, you only need to write out your cumulative frequency and the upper class boundary. Cumulative frequency stays at the vertical side, while the upper class boundary stays at the horizontal axis. So now, having made the table, I'm going to draw a smaller table that will contain just the cumulative frequency and the upper class boundary, because they are the two key information we need to plot the graph. So let us go into the actual plotting of the graph.
We've successfully completed the table.
Let us move into the graph proper. As you can see, we have our cumulative frequency and our upper class boundary. And you know that the ogive is plotted using the cumulative frequency at the vertical axis, while the upper class boundary will be at the horizontal axis, that is the yx axis. Okay, now I've made something for us here. I've drawn the vertical and the horizontal axis, which are the y and x axis, and I've given values for x, for y 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. I'm using this scale because of what I have here in the cumulative frequency. I have up to 50 there. And the writing 1, 2, 3 may not be able to help me contain my values in this graph here, because 1, 2, 3 cannot reach up to 50. Even if I say 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, or 5, 10, 15, it may not help me. The graph might be looking so small. Okay, so since I'm jumping two boxes to write 10, it means it is 2 cm to 10 units. If I'm writing 5, 10, 15, it means that my scale is 2 cm to 5 units. So this time around that I'm writing 10, 20, 30, 40, my scale is now 2 cm to 10 units. Then again, we have to put up the values under the x axis. And as you can see, the first thing we are having here is 10.5. So we can call here 10.5. Then here is 20.5. Here is 30.5. 40.5. We have 50.5. And 60.5. So you have to make the point that owns the value you are writing. There are a lot of arguments against what I've just done here, because normally from year to year is 10.5. There are 10.5 spaces between 0 and here, but from here to here is 20.5, only 10 spaces that are there. Okay, but we assume that the starting point here is 0.5. So how 0.5 to 10.5, not just 0 to 10.5, which still makes it 10. Okay, so
At this point, let us key in these values into this graph to get our ogive immediately. So we have cumulative frequency of 6 and upper class boundary of 10.5. Now, you know that there is no 6 under this vertical axis, that is my cumulative frequency. But since I'm counting 10, 20, 30, there are 10 small lines here before I get to from 10 to 20. Another 10 small lines before I get to 30, etc. So there are 10 small lines there when I'm counting in 10. So I will divide 10 by 10. Hence, each small line is one unit. Therefore, to plot in 6 there, you start from the origin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. This is 6. But the 6 goes with 10.5. And look at 10.5 here when you're having 6. So you mark an asterisk here to denote that 6 and 10.5 are together. Then cumulative frequency of 12 and the upper class boundary of 20.5. So if I is 10, 12 will be 11 and 12. Then trace it to 20.5. So you mark it here. So this is 20.5 and 12. The next item there is 24 and 30.5. You look for 24. Here is 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 30.5. So look for 30.5. Look at it here. You mark another asterisk. Then after that, you have 35 and 40.5. 35. If here is 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, then look for 40.5. And look at where we are having our 40.5 here. You mark an asterisk. We have 45 and 50.5. So if here is 40, 45 is somewhere here if you count. Then look for 50.5. This is 50.5 down here. Then finally, we have our 50 and 60.5. And look at 50 here, up here. And 60.5. Look at 60.5. We look for it and plot together. So you've now seen how I have successfully plotted all these points together in the curve. Then after that, if you have a French curve, you can use it to join the points together. If you don't have, a ruler can help you. We can still use a ruler to plot and join the point. So let me join the point now so you can see how it is done. So I have successfully plotted the ogive. You see how it is sloping like elongated X. So this is just the ogive for the question that is asked. Now, having drawn this ogive, the question expected us to get so many other things. According to the first question there, we are asked to get the median. How do we get the median? Now, you know that the median is halfway. And the sum of the frequencies we are having is 50. So if you want to get the median, divide 50 by 2. So median now, I will divide 50 by 2. And if I divide 50 by 2, I'm getting 25. But this 25 is not your answer. You have to go to your graph, look for 25, okay, under the cumulative frequency. So if here is 20, 25 is somewhere here in between 20 and 30. With your ruler, don't do it the way I'm doing it. You trace from that 25 until it touches your curve. This is the point is touching my curve. At that point is touching your curve, bring it down in the x-axis. You bring it down. You can see the way I'm doing it. It is touching it somewhere here. And after 30.5, the next line here is 1, so you can call it 31.5. Since here is 30, you have one more line after 30. So I can say that my median is equal to 31.5 from the graph. So I've got the median. Let me go ahead and get the next question, because the question is not only median, it also wants us to get the lower quartile. Lower quartile. Lower quartile is Q1. The formula for lower quartile is N over 4. N is not the sum of your frequency, or summation F over 4. And the frequency is 50. I will divide 50 by 4. this will give me 12.5. So having got, you know, all these things I'm writing here, you're not supposed to write it on the graph page. There is a fresh page where you have to do it in your examination. Okay, so 12.5. You go to your graph again and look for 12.5. So if here is 10, here is 11, here is 12. So 12.5 is midway here. 12.5 is touching it somewhere here. You bring it down at the point it's touching it. It is halfway, and one line is 1 unit, and half means you divide is 0.5, it's not up to 1. So when I add 0.5 to 20.5, I'm getting a 21. So Q1 is equal to 21. Since this point is 20, half of it is 0.5, not up to 1. So if I add it, I'm getting 21 as my Q1. So apart from Q1, which is the lower quartile, they still want us to get the upper quartile. And the upper quartile is your Q3. Q3 is the upper quartile. And the formula for upper quartile is 3n all over 4. So n is 50, the sum of the frequencies. Multiply 50 by 3, you get 150. Divide 150 by 4, you get 37.5. So Q3 is 37.5 because n is 50. Multiply 50 by 3 and divide by 4, it will give you 37.5. But 37.5 is not the answer. You have to go to your graph again to look for 37.5. Okay, now here is 30, here is 35, 36, 37. 37.5 is halfway here. You trace it again to the curve. Don't mind what I've written here. You trace it again to the curve. Look at the point is touching it. You bring it down again. You see the way I'm doing it? I'm bringing it down. So look at the point is touching it. Here is 40.5, 41.5, 42.5. And this is halfway, which is 43, not up to 44.5. Remember, here is 40.5, 41.5, 42.5, then plus half, which is 43. So our Q3 is equal to 43. So having got Q3, you can still get interquartile range, which is the next question. Q3 is the upper quartile, while Q1 is the lower quartile. So the question still wants us to get the interquartile range. Remember, range is the difference between the highest and the lowest value. Okay? So, and the highest, which is the upper quartile, is 43. The lowest, which is the lower quartile, is 21. So the interquartile range will now be 43 minus 21. If I subtract, I'm getting 22. So the interquartile range is 22. So having got the interquartile range as 22, they still want us to get the semi-interquartile range. Semi means half. So semi-interquartile range means dividing your interquartile range by 2. And since our interquartile range is 22, just divide 22 by 2, it will give you 11. Therefore, semi-interquartile range will give us 11, dividing the interquartile range by 2, because semi is half. So if you've not seen how we've resolved this to get the upper quartile and lower quartile, to do that, you have to get your lower quartile first, Q1, and the formula is n over 4. N is the sum of the frequencies. You divide by 4, you get 12.5. At each point in time, you trace it in your graph and read off the value at the horizontal axis. But this is not all the question that is asked. They still want us to get the 80th percentile and 6th decile. So let's see how to get them. The 80th percentile and the 6th decile. So 80th percentile is just like a percentage, that is 80th percentile. And 80th percentile means 80 over 100. So 80th percentile means 80 over 100 times the sum of your frequencies. And the sum of our frequencies is just 50 over 1. 0 cancels 0, 0 cancels 0. 8 times 5 will give us 40. So the 80 percentile is at 40. But 40 is not the answer. You have to go to the graph again. Look at where you're having 40. You trace it in the graph. 40, because you got 40 as the 80 percentile. Trace it to your graph. It is touching it somewhere here. You bring it down. As I'm bringing it down, I found out that it is touching the horizontal axis at this point. If here is 40.5, you have 41.5, 42.5, 43.5, 44.5, and 45.5. So the 80th percentile is 45.5. That's my 80th percentile. Then finally, we are asked to get the 6th decile. 6th decile. Decile is talking about over 10. So 6th decile means 6 decile means 6 over 10. If you are told third decile, it is 3 over 10. If you are told fourth decile, it is 4 over 10. And since I'm told 6th decile, it is just 6 over 10 times that sum of frequency, which is 50 over 1. 0 cancels 0. So 6 times 5 is giving me 30. So my decile, my 6th decile, is around 30. Go to the graph also and read off the value. You go to your graph and trace it, 30, because the 6th decile gave me 30. 6th decile is equivalent to 60th percentile. It's touching it somewhere here. You bring it down to this point and look at the value it's giving us. And you know that here is 30.5. So you have 31.5, 32.5, 33.5, 34.5, and 35.5. So my 6th decile is 35.5. At this point in time, we are coming to the expiration of this class. I wish you good luck in your WAEC examination tomorrow. Kindly hit the red button to subscribe to my channel. It gives you notification whenever a new video is out. Thank you so much.